welcome back to Focal Point AFR Talk, this Friday edition, Sanctity of Life edition of Focal Point on the American Family Radio Talk Network. My name is Brian Fisher. The program is Focal Point. The network is AFR Talk, the American Family Radio Talk Network. Honored and pleased to welcome to our decision maker line Ryan Scott Bomberger. Ryan is the co-founder of the Radiance Foundation, and we want to chat with them about what they're involved in. Ryan, welcome to Focal Point with Brian Fisher.
Brian, it's great to be with you.
Well, Ryan, let's talk first of all about the Radiance Foundation. This is a 501c3. It's founded by you and by your wife, Bethany. Tell us what the Radiance Foundation is all about.
Well, my wife, Bethany, and I started about 4 years ago, and our heart was really just to reach out to the broken. Our mission is really to get people to understand and embrace their intrinsic value. And the way that we do that through national ag campaigns, through multimedia presentations on campuses, at churches, high schools. And then we also have community outreach efforts like our Sally's Lambs outreach to birth moms who choose adoption. So we do all that to illuminate God-given purpose.
And where can people, we're going to come back to this again, cycle back to it, but where can people get more information, Scott, about what you and Bethany are doing and the Radiance Foundation?
They can jump on to theradiancefoundation.org and find out about the work that we do and all the media that we create and our efforts to try to illuminate that irreplaceable intrinsic value we all possess.
Well, and you were involved. I want to cycle back to kind of your life story, but before we get to that, I want you to have you talk to us a little bit about the billboard campaign that you started. Got a lot of attention. New York Times talked about it. USA Today talked about it. LA Times talked about it. CNN talked about it. MSNBC, AP, Washington Times, Fox, Diane Sawyer, ABC World News. So tell us a little bit about that campaign, what it was, where the inspiration came from, and what kind of impact it had.
Well, you know, I'm an adoptee, and I'm an adoptive father. And, you know, when you look at how abortion is pushed as the only possible solution to unplanned pregnancy, you know, for years as an adoption advocate, I would get so frustrated. So when we started the Radiance Foundation, we wanted to launch an ad campaign that actually exposed where abortion's impact is most disproportionately impacting in our society, and that is the Black community. You know, as someone who is as Black as Obama, I felt that this would be an issue that we could tackle. So we decided to combine race and abortion, which we actually didn't initiate. The abortion industry combined race and abortion from its inception. And we exposed Planned Parenthood through our TooManyAborted.com billboards. We placed about 80 billboards around the metro Atlanta area and got a response from media that we did not expect. It was pretty overwhelming.
Hmm. And, you know, it's interesting when you talk about Planned Parenthood, Scott or Ryan, I'd like you to sort of respond to this. But, you know, I've seen some of the figures about Planned Parenthood, and they will say essentially that they're a full-service maternal health organization. They're here for women's health. They're here for reproductive assistance and all that kind of a thing. And so they create the impression that, yeah, that we're about abortions. We're about adoption as well as abortion. But the reality is, and I'd like you to comment on this, the reality is that Planned Parenthood is far more about abortion than they are about adoption.
Planned Parenthood's entire business model is centered on abortion. That's what they do. Abortion is what they do. 333,964 abortions in their latest, according to their latest annual report, which is a record number of abortions for them. That's what they do. That's what brings in their money. Their cancer screenings, their small number of cancer screenings, their STD treatments and all that pale in comparison. It doesn't bring them in money. So the revenue comes from abortion. And you see that, you know, through the numbers. And just by using their own annual reports, they abort 167 children for every one adoption referral. So an organization that counts itself as being pro-choice, although recently they want to shed that label, which is probably fitting because they're not about choice. They don't offer women the beautiful option of adoption, and they don't provide the kind of prenatal services and other services that women need in pregnancy. They're all about abortion.
Talking here with Ryan Scott Bomberg of the Bomberger of the Radiance Foundation, co-founder of that organization, along with his wife Bethany. And Ryan, tell us a little bit about your own story, your own life story, and some of the lessons from your own life story that touch on the sanctity of life issue.
You know, it's hard not to be as passionate about this issue as I am, having, you know, grown up in a multiracial family of 15, 10 of us were adopted, and I was the first one adopted. And, you know, having a biological mother who had to face the horrific act of rape, she still went through 9 months of a traumatic pregnancy and chose life for me and placed me for adoption and gave me such an incredible life. Two parents who loved the mess out of each and every one of us. And so that really set the wheels in motion. That's why being so passionate about defending all human life, regardless of circumstances, is part of my DNA. And so we've been afforded all kinds of opportunities through our work through the Radiance Foundation in exposing the racism and eugenics of Planned Parenthood, but how really the abortion industry is the antithesis to purpose.
Hmm. Well, and you talk about the racial component to the work that Planned Parenthood does, and I want you to talk about that just for a moment, about, you know, that's a pretty strong statement to make. I've made it a number of times myself, but I want to ask you to elaborate a little bit about that when you talk about how racially imbalanced or maybe even racially targeted the abortion industry is, particularly when you're looking at Planned Parenthood.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, let's look at Planned Parenthood's home city, New York City. Black babies are aborted 6 times more than white babies in that city. In fact, more black babies are aborted than are born alive. 1,489 black babies die for every 1,000 that are born alive. This is not by mistake. It is by design. Planned Parenthood was founded on this whole eugenics movement in America during the early 20th century. And people have to understand, you can't look at present stats without having an appreciation of the history. So putting that into context, looking at the American Eugenics Society and how it was deeply racist, based on all kinds of pseudoscience that wanted to eliminate certain people from the gene pool, basically, and that had to do with those who were black and poor, those who were disabled, those who were incarcerated. They labeled certain people unfit, and that specific targeting has never ended. In fact, one of the things we take on, we have something called the Negro Project 2.0, which is just reiterating the original Negro Project that was launched by Planned Parenthood, where they used influential black members to convince the black community that, hey, birth control is the solution. It's the answer. It's going to be the uplift out of poverty. And it's all a lie. It's all propaganda. But it's all the same today. And eugenics is alive and tragically well in the United States and globally today.
You know, cycling back to one thing you said earlier, Ryan, about the fact that you were conceived in rape. And I want you to elaborate a little bit on, you know, because that's one of the exceptions that even people in the pro-life community seem to be willing to accept. Well, yeah, if the child was conceived in incest, if the child was conceived through an act of rape, well, then it's okay to go ahead and snuff out the life of that baby. Your response to that?
Well, I thank God for the courage of my birth mom who did not make that choice, and there are many birth moms who don't. In fact, this is why, you know, in the mainstream media, they don't allow a substantive conversation about this. One, the act of rape is horrible. It is violent. But here's the problem. Abortion never brings healing. Abortion never unrapes a woman, and it never punishes the rapist. And we never get to that part of the conversation. Instead, it's all about, unfortunately, the innocent child facing a horrible demise. The problem with the issue of rape and not being able to have any kind of conversation about it is because it's always used as the justification for 100% of abortions. So for those who want to write off, you know, people like me and these fringe examples, they call them the hard cases, but I consider myself and others like me the heart cases, because we have to dig deeper and realize that Planned Parenthood is actually the perfect cover-up for rapists. In fact, that's why they've been taken to court, because they have covered up rape over and over again, allowing these criminals to do the same thing to these women and these young girls over and over again. So the conversation has to be much, but we have to realize the pro-abortion side is always going to use rape as an excuse for all abortions.
Well, and it touches on a larger issue of justice. There are repeated statements in the Old Testament prohibiting punishing a child for the sins or the crimes of its father. That's not what a just society does, but when we put a child to death who has been conceived in rape, then we are carrying out the death penalty on the child, and the rapist, with the help of Planned Parenthood, might just get off scot-free.
And that's what happens. That's the world of this pro-abortion mentality, because it's an inverted world where justice, where you're supposed to protect the weaker from the stronger, or those who have, you know, had things inflicted upon them. But it reverses all this. It inverts all of that. And so the weaker are actually, they end up being the target, and they're the ones who end up being attacked. And, you know, women are, this is what I hear. I travel across the country, I speak to so many, and I find the story is the same for so many post, from people who are rape survivors who either are post-abortive or have chosen to carry their child to term, but they say the same thing, that abortion is like a second rape.
Mm.
And in that situation, you have someone who inflicts harm or violence upon the woman, causes pain and even death, and then abandons them. That's what an abortionist does.
Hmm. One last comment. Go ahead and finish your thought, Ryan.
I'm sorry. I'm just saying that's why I feel like you can't possibly get a conversation of any kind of depth from mainstream media. But these are the things that we try to talk about in our conversations and our events across the country.
And one last comment, Ryan, just 30 seconds. But, you know, Planned Parenthood says every child a wanted child. So let's abort children that are conceived in rape because they're not wanted. But your experience is you were conceived in rape, but you were wanted very badly. Your mother wanted you enough to give you life. And there was a couple out there that wanted you enough to adopt you into their family and raise you. 30 seconds.
Let me just tell you, this is what we illuminate on the RadianceFoundation.org. That you can watch a video of the story of my life, and the end of it, it says we're all wanted by someone. It doesn't matter the circumstances. There's no such thing as an unwanted child, and there are millions of us out there who have been adopted or whose mothers have chosen to parent them, who defy the myth of the unwanted every single day. And that's why I do what I do.
Our guest has been Ryan Scott Bomberger, co-founder along with his wife, Bethany, of the Radiance Foundation. You can get more information by going to theradiancefoundation.org. Ryan, thank you for taking time to be with us, and God bless you and your ministry. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brian.
Ryan Scott Bomberger of the Radiance Foundation, back with more. Stay with us, Focal Point AFR Talk.